Will Eddie Brock be eaten alive by his new terrifying Norse-inspired costume? Well, let's hop into the pages of Venom issue number 15 and find out for ourselves, shall we? Alrighty then, so picking up from where the last issue left off, Jack-O-Lantern, who had been empowered by the very same Dark Elf Witch who had given Eddie a new lease on power, decided that if he couldn't beat his foe Eddie Brock in a fair fight, he'll just make it a very unfair fight by taking out his aggression on the entire city and everyone in it by burning it all up. Now, normally for Eddie, beating a guy like this should be no problem, but for whatever reason, he just can't keep up with him. That Dark Elf Dreamstone is really starting to take its toll on him. It's feeding on his anger, twisting him, corrupting him, turning him into something ugly, something he feared he would never be again. And while Jack-O-Lantern is actually super creative in his use of the stone, Eddie, for whatever reason, just cannot seem to tap into that part of his brain right now. He also continues to beat himself up about what happened with the symbiote and why he essentially has to go it alone here right now. It's perhaps, though, for all those same reasons, though, Eddie Brock swears he's not going to be a victim anymore. He's going to use his anger, and his anger isn't going to use him. Because of that, the costume transforms once again. But even though it looks even cooler now, he still might not be able to get the job done. That is, however, until he stops and reflects on his son, Dylan, the person who he's trying the hardest to protect right now. Maybe Eddie's very problem since the beginning was feeling that this was an all-or-nothing kind of affair, and if he can't make the Dreamstone work for him, well, maybe other people can. And instead of putting himself in harm's way to try and protect people from Jack, maybe he should empower other people to be able to fight Jack on their own. Essentially, we are Venom. We're all Venom today. This crazy gamble ends up paying off huge. Jack is defeated, losing his Dreamstone, and making himself just a regular, normal guy. Eddie could potentially have taken his life right there, right now, but he chooses not to. Because that would be using his anger in a negative way, and he's learned a lot about where to direct that sort of thing. All he's worried about now is getting back to his son, who he still hasn't actually told is his son yet, by the way. Dylan turned out to be just fine, by the way. Well, as fine as you can be when you lock a small child in a room filled with a bunch of loaded weapons. But hey, Eddie ain't trying for Father of the Year anytime soon. It's all baby steps. Now that they're both reunited and that nothing is trying to kill them at present, they decide they're just gonna hunker down and lay low until this whole War of Realms things blows over. After all, the symbiotes are going to be getting their own event fairly soon in Absolute Carnage, so they better get nice and rested up for that as the comic comes to a close. And so that was Venom issue number 15, everybody, and I felt Cullen Bunn was able to deliver a pretty workmanlike little tie-in story that probably could have worked just as well with two issues instead of three. It is certainly nice to see Eddie forced to re-examine his own life and his own toxic relationship with the symbiote and realize that it may not have just been the black costume's fault, and that he has a lot of issues he needs to work out before he can ever be in a quote-unquote healthy relationship with any alien costume, or any person for that matter. My biggest problem is that everything is stretched a little thin. Eddie really doesn't have much of an effect on the War of Realms as a whole, or vice versa for that matter. Also, despite his magic supercharging, Jack-O-Lantern continues to not really be a compelling villain. In fact, I dare say he's one of Marvel's least compelling villains, and there's been like several different Jack-O-Lanterns over the years. But man alive, did Coelho do some amazing things on art. All the different versions of the Norse-inspired runic symbiote Venom suit, that's some good stuff right there. Like, it's so good, I hope we see it again someday, even if it's just as downloadable content in a video game somewhere. Ultimately, I give this a 7 out of 10. It was perfectly adequate.
Oh, hey there, didn't see you come in. I'm Cape Jewel. Thanks so much for watching to the end of the video. I'm just hanging out here, trying to figure out how to keep these intros fresh and interesting for everybody. Like the video, that would be nice, I'd appreciate it, but I'm not going to push you to do it. You can also follow me on Twitter and Facebook, at Cape Jewel, so you can keep up to date on what I'm doing next. I have an Instagram. I feel like I don't push the Instagram enough, but I have it. I have a backup gameplay channel as well. I get the feeling people who watch my comic content don't really want to watch me play video games, at least that's what the numbers would tell me, but it's the Jewel Daily channel. You can also see me play games live on the Cape Jewel Twitch. I got a tip jar down there, I got a Patreon page, got an Amazon wish list. Some of you were really nice to do that for me. That's where I get fun, cool sweaters like this off my Amazon wish list. I appreciate the people who do that. It's really nice of them. And yeah, that's all I got to say. Man, it's hard to try and keep these outros fresh sometimes, I tell you. But thanks again for watching, and I'll be back again later, smacking those comics up, man. Just doing it. Did I call it comic smack because I make the smack sound, or am I saying that comics are my addiction and that's why it's comic smack? I dropped the comic smack after a bit because the channel is called Cape Joel. I should really have called it All Comic Smack from the beginning of with. Oh, well, hindsight's 2020. Goodbye, everyone!